We're asked to determine whether the following are multiplication or division problems. Sort the questions into the appropriate category. For A, Daphne paid $87 a month for 2 years for internet service. How much did she pay in total? There are 12 months in 1 year, and therefore there are 24 months in 2 years. She paid $87 24 times over the 2 years. To determine the total she paid, we multiply 24 and 87. 24 times 87 equals 2,088, which means Daphne paid $2,088 over 2 years for internet service. Now this question does not ask us to determine the product, it just asks to determine whether we use multiplication or division. Because we use multiplication, we enter A in the multiplication box. For B, Irene shared 32 candies with 4 friends. How many candies did each friend receive? So she has a total of 32 candies. She's going to break them into 4 equally sized groups for her 4 friends. And therefore, to determine how many candies each friend receives, we perform division. 32 divided by 4 equals 8. Each friend receives 8 candies. We use division, and therefore we place B in the division box. For C, each apple pie receives 3 cups of sugar. If Sharon has 12 cups of sugar, how many pies can she bake? Because each pie requires 3 cups of sugar, and she has 12 cups of sugar, if we determine how many 3s in 12, we can determine how many pies she can bake. To determine how many 3s are in 12, we divide 12 by 3. 12 divided by 3 equals 4, which means that Sharon can bake 4 pies. We use division, and therefore we place C, and therefore we place C in the division box. For D, Roberta drove 65 miles an hour for 7 hours. How far did she drive? Well, her rate is 65 miles per hour or per 1 hour, and she drove for 7 hours, and therefore 65 times 7 will give us how far she drove. Well, 65 times 7 equals 455, which means Roberta drove 455 miles over the 7 hours. We use multiplication, we place D in the multiplication box. For E, Rudy's airplane descended 1,638 meters in 7 minutes. How many feet did it descend per minute? So the given rate is the descent of 1,638 meters per 7 minutes. To represent the descent, we would use negative 1,638. And therefore, to determine the descent per minute, we divide. We would have negative 1,638 divided by 7, which equals negative 234. This negative value represents a descent of 234 meters per minute. We use division, we place E in the division box. For F, Teresa bought 8 boxes of chocolates. There are 18 pieces of chocolate per box. How many chocolates did she buy? Well, because each box contains 18 pieces of chocolate and she has 8 boxes, 8 times 18 gives us a total number of chocolates. 8 times 18 equals 144. We use multiplication, we place F in the multiplication box. For G, Jose is driving home for the holidays. His home is 871 miles away. If he drives for 13 hours, how fast did he travel per hour? From the given information, we have a rate of 871 miles per 13 hours, which represents a quotient. So if we have 871 and we divide by 13, this will tell us how fast he traveled per hour. 871 divided by 13 equals 67. This quotient tells us Jose drove an average of 67 miles per hour. We perform division, we place G in the division box. And then finally for H, Laura swam 17 laps. Each lap was 50 meters. How many meters did she swim? Well, she swam 50 meters 17 times because she swam 17 laps. 17 times 50 will give us the total distance, or total meters, that she swam. 17 times 50 equals 850. She swam a total distance of 850 meters. We perform multiplication to solve the problem. We place H in the multiplication box. I hope you found this helpful.